As a farmer in this productive nation of ours, you have unequaled independence of action and the complete freedom to choose the equipment you believe meets your needs best of all. This invariably brings together machines in all the colors of the rainbow: red, orange, yellow, green, blue, and purple too, perhaps. One color may be dominant in your collection of farm equipment, and you may prefer tractors of a particular make. Whatever that may be, we'd like to present a complimentary implement that's unsurpassed in performance, and that can be matched to a tractor of any color perfectly. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, yes, even purple.
Back, everybody. This is a video that quite a few of you have been hoping to see. At least that's what I've seen in the comments. We have got the purple, or pink as some of you may call it, but Oliver called it purple. Purple 1850. This is a tribute tractor I painted up for my daughter. But Oliver, for those of you not familiar with it, Oliver did paint a few up like this around 1966 as a promotion to sell plows. It didn't matter what color your plow was. The Oliver was the color, I'm sorry, it didn't matter what color your tractor was. The Oliver was the colorblind plow. It didn't matter if your tractor was green, orange, blue, red, or even purple. The Oliver plow was the best one to put behind it. The promotion was the brainchild of Gene Keene. He had been driving through Charles City and parked at the bank, I think belonging to the banker, was a brand new Lincoln that was painted this color, and he recalled how it caught his eye, and he thought this would be a great way to catch the eyes of customers. So they painted one up for a dealer meeting and came up with this colorblind plow promotion. It was such a big hit, they ended up painting several more up. Each dealer warehouse, or regional warehouse, was to pull one. I've been told at Omaha, I actually pulled two out, take it to a local body shop, paint it up like this, go around to the shows, the fairs, dealers, promote it, and then at the end, they'd take them back, paint them back to green, and sell them as the demonstrator tractors. So there's really no good record of which ones were this color. I know this was definitely not one. This is a very early 1850. Notice how it does not have the notch cut out in the frame for the rear motor mount bolts, which makes it a pain in the butt. But it was, those were in by the time they did the purple tractor promotion. So not trying to pass this off as an original, just a tribute tractor, something for my daughter and something just to have something different at the shows. This 548 Oliver, 516s. This is the first plow I personally bought. We had one on the farm here. I'm a good customer. I was over, took a tractor back to him. Maybe it was a skid steer, that don't really matter. But here's this plow in his barn. And so I said, oh, are you interested in selling that plow? He said, I've had this thing out, parked out in a couple different places trying to sell it. Couldn't get any interest in it. Had it all the way down to, I think he said, $100. And just couldn't get any bites. This was back in the late 80s, early 90s. Probably would have been the 90s. But anyways, just couldn't get a bite on it. And I told him I'd give him $300 for it and no questions asked. And that was still a steal. So bought it off from him. I should be keeping it inside. It's a pretty nice original and the paint's getting a little weathered and only so much space here on the farm. But it does a nice job. I've always been happy with it. So that's part of the reason I hooked it up. It's a good match for an 1850. Mom also wanted her garden plowed, so I figured, well, let's do it in style. First, we'll take her out to the field. I think it's just soybean stubble, but do a little plot out there, and then maybe we can compare some no-till to tillage and just have some fun. I mean, that's what it's really about. So let's get her started, get a little warmth in the engine. I was running it earlier, but I had to fix the tire on the plow. It feels like she's pretty well cooled back off. Everything seems to be going good. Smell of paint that's gotten hot for the first time. Good and hot. I mean, she's run, but everything polished up, no problem. Hear that? I heard something. Now the old 548's doing a beautiful job. Of course, my sandy soil turns over nice, and the moisture is just about perfect. So, whoop! I heard it again. There. There. Oh my God. Oh my God. Is it Sasquatch? Oh my God, it's raw squatch. What in the world? Okay, Ophelia, someone else's turn. You did a good job. We'll drop this off and pick the next toy. Well, after the whole injection pump fiasco, I think the 1800 deserves to do a little work. So, parked Ophelia, and got the 1800 out. Let's go see if she's gonna work. Probably be some smoke when that fuel burns off. Probably should have just washed it, but here we are. now the sun is, well, the sun is gone. I got up to the woods, which is what I wanted to do. Of course, I could have started closer to the woods. But as you can see, them trees are reaching out into the field. And, well, they're gonna have to reach again. There's some blackberries in there too, so I don't really wanna reach in and grab all the thorns. Looks like the shares are ready to be replaced. But some good quality recreational tillage for me. 1800s purring nice. Beautiful sunset, and it's supposed to be nasty for the next several days. As always, I appreciate everybody watching, commenting, doing all the stuff you do, supporting my channel. We will see you in the next one.